Now, if you have another presentation out there that you want to be able to copy the slides over, reuse those slides, because if you already worked on it, created it, why shovel the same dirt twice or recreate the same thing? Just bring it on over. So I've got my presentation here that has a total of 4 slides. Let me minimize that down to the taskbar. And I have another presentation, GOPS. Double click to open it up. And it's Ghost or Paranormal Society. We have our annual meeting, and then slide 2. Schedule for today, and then the bulleted points. So, if I want to go ahead and use one of these slides in my other presentation, like I said, one of the things we can do is copy it, and you can do it one of a couple of ways. Like if you want both slides, then just, select one and hold down the control key and click on the other, and then you can right click and go to copy. Let's just do one. Let me click down below to deselect that one, and let me go ahead and right click on it and go to copy. And that's it. Let's just go ahead and close out of here. Come back down to the taskbar to click on the button to restore that window. And let's go ahead and select slide 3. So whatever slide I have selected, when I click paste, it's going to paste it after. So I can either go ahead and right click and I get my paste options here, or you can come up here, let me click off, on the home tab on the clipboard and click on the paste button, or you get your paste options there. So if I click on the paste button or Control V as in Victor, it pastes it in, but it keeps it with the same theme, so I don't get that other theme, the colors, fonts, and effects, but I do get the text. So if I want that other theme, I do have my paste options until I perform another action that it will cause this little tag to disappear. So if I go ahead and click on the drop-down arrow, there it is, use destination themes. So the destination is this theme, or I can keep the source formatting. When I click on it, it keeps its theme, its format. Oh, that's nice. And the other option, click on it, is to convert it into a picture. When you do that, it takes it and puts it on the slide that we pasted on. That would have come after, but now it's on top of it. And you still get your paste options if you want to revert back to a destination theme so it's in its own slide. In any case, you got the resizing handles. You can click and drag to fit it there, however you'd like. I'm going to go ahead and with it selected, hit the delete key on the keyboard. Now that's one way. The other way without opening up the other presentation is to come up here. Well, before you do it this way, just make sure whatever slide you have selected, when you do it this other way, it will insert it after that slide. So slide 3 is good. Come up here on the Home tab in the Slides group, click on New Slide, and go down and to say that you want to reuse a slide in another presentation. Click on it. Opens up the task pane, and it says, where's the slide? Let's browse for it. You do have what's called a slide library that we'll talk about in a later training video, and you can go to that when you build up a library of slides that you'll be using in future presentations. Well, that's your library, and so you can go ahead and choose one of those. But let's go ahead and browse for that file that's on our desktop that's called GOPS. Go ahead and double click on it, automatically links it up, and you get the slides that are in there, and it's got a total of 2. You can see when I hover over the first slide, it's got the title of it and that title of the slide. Well, they're both the same, so let's go down below and you can see the title of the presentation and then the title below that of the slide is scheduled for today. So to go ahead and add one, you can either click on it or, when in doubt, you'll get more options, right click, and you can insert that slide or all the slides, a total of 2. You can apply a theme to all slides or apply the theme, the fonts, colors, and effects from this one to the selected slide. So if I just click on one, it adds it, but it doesn't keep the source formatting. I mean, you do get this option down below that you can check. And then click on it again to add it again, and it keeps the source formatting. So I have it listed twice, one without the source formatting, and then the one that had the source formatting with it. So with it selected, I'll hit the delete key and hit the delete key and uncheck that. And then if you just like the formatting that you want to apply to one of your slides, like again, back to slide 3, then of course you can right click and say, you know what? I want to apply the theme to this selected slide. Click on it and it updates it. Oh, that's unique. And then if I go ahead and I'm done and I close out, I'm like, you know, I really would like the original theme. Well, let's come up here, click on the design tab, go to the themes group, and now we've got, well, what's the original theme? I believe it's that one right there. The only way I'm going to find out is you can see how that one's highlighted in orange because that's the one that's applied to the selected slide. When I select another one, it highlights that one. Hover over it. That one's called Metro, And you can see it's used by slides 1 through 2 and then 4 in that little pop-up. And then this one, you hover over it, it's used by slides 3. So I can just go ahead and select that one and click on it. And we're back to its original theme. Thanks for watching. Hey, as a quick reminder, if you like my video, please give it a thumbs up. You can also click on me and subscribe to my channel to get notified of the latest videos. And for great specials on my products, please see the description below this video.